about a very important function that is called keep filters. So let's elaborate this function with the help of an example. Here again I'm using the same data model, the student and marks, and we have one to many relationship. I have made this model very simple so that we can understand our DAX properly. So the most important thing is the underlying concepts, and then you can use these concepts in any complex situations according to your requirement. So I have added subject on the matrix, as you can see here, and I have already created one measure called total marks. This is the formula, sum x, the first parameter is the marks, and then we are providing midterm marks plus final term marks. Let's drag and drop here, and here we can see every subject with its total marks, biochemistry, chemistry, and some others. So let's create one more measure. Like a female marks, and we will write calculate. The first parameter will be expression, that is total marks, and gender is equal to female F. And let's drag and drop female marks, and here you can see we have total marks bio, and for the female students we have total marks for the female students 180, chemistry is 270, and some other stuff that you can see in the visual. So let's put one slicer here. You can put slicer like gender. So if I select female F, and you will see the two columns have the identical marks. Total marks for the bio 180 and female marks is 180. And if I select male, you can see the total marks is changing depending on the slicer, but female marks is not replacing anymore. You know, whether I select female or male or both, so it doesn't have any effect on the female marks. The reason is, if I look at female marks measure, and here we have written calculate, which is replacing the filter in the gender column. So the gender column has been replaced with F, with a female. So if I select female or male, it doesn't make any effect on this column female marks, because everything it is replaced with F. So now the requirement is, let's write one more measure to calculate the percentage. Marks percentage, we used one function divide, the numerator will be female marks divided by total marks, and we will format it and here you can see we are getting appropriate marks. Like for the bio we have 62%, 56%, and if I select female it is showing 100% because both column have the identical values. But if I select male, and here you can see we are getting 163%. 131%, 171%, so on. So this is not correct. The reason is when I select male, then these marks, these total marks have been changed according to the selection here. But the female marks are always greater than the male marks. That's why we are getting higher percentage. So instead of replacing or removing the gender filter, we need some function so that this gender column should be added into the filters. So how we will do this? Let's go to the female marks, and then we have to write keep filter. And here you can see, if I select male, it is blank. Why it is blank? Because the key filter will do the intersect between the external filter and the filter that we have applied here. So there is nothing common between F and M. That's why we are getting nothing. But if I select female, then it is 100%, because in both column F is common, so we will get the female marks here, 180. But if I select both female and male, and then you will see between female and male the common thing is F, which is female, and that's why we will get the female marks in the matrix. So the basic purpose of key filter is to add the external filters instead of replacing. So here you can read the description on the Microsoft website that you use the key filters within the context of calculate and calculatable function to override the standard behavior of those function. And what is the standard behavior of calculate? Normally calculate was replacing the gender with female, and with the help of key filters we have added the external filter as an intersect with the filters that we have applied here, and now we are getting the appropriate result.